we drinking?
We are drinking, well, I don't know what you're drinking, but I'm drinking a hot chocolate from Boon Boon, a coffee shop here in Renton. And the reason why I was so intrigued with this place is because there's so much culture and tradition in this part of Renton.
So it must mean you like the coffee or like the hot chocolate.
Funny thing, I'm actually not a coffee drinker. Yeah. But he does make a good cup of hot chocolate, and I am a hot chocolate connoisseur, so.
Are you watching football anymore?
Occasionally.
I can tell just looking at your Twitter account, you care about what's going on in the country and politically.
It's hard not to, right? I'm kind of in a special place in my life right now. I got two daughters that I'm raising, and you know, I look out in the world and it's like, I don't like what I see in a lot of places, especially as an African-American man living in America, growing up in the South, coming to the West Coast and seeing all the different changes and perspectives that I've seen. I want to be a part of the change that sees my daughters live in a world that's better than the one that I grew up in.
Where did that kind of change in perspective happen?
Part of it is just the natural progression of learning who I was. I think for a lot of the time, especially in the entertainment business, you're entertaining. It's kind of hard to be yourself, authentically yourself.
2016, 2017, though, it seemed like things changed. There was all the discussion from the president about whether players should kneel or not, how they should honor the flag. It seemed like you became the go-to person to weigh in on that. Were you thinking at the time, I'm challenging the president, I'm taking a stand here and this is the time to do it?
I didn't look at it in the sense of challenging the president. I looked at it as standing up for what I believed and thought was right. The office of the presidency, in my view, is an office that serves the people. And when people are saying that, you know, something is wrong, and the person who's in that office doesn't take the consideration to say, okay, hold on, let me listen to you and really empathize and understand, I have a problem with that.
Yeah, I think at one point you called him an idiot.
Yeah, I did.
He's an idiot, plain and simple.
I think I did not too long ago on Twitter too. It's really hard for me to understand his supporters, right? Because there's a human element to it that is missing.
You were talking about issues in 2017, 2018 that only now in 2020 and in 2021 that people are realizing. You talked about things like implicit bias, that you didn't want to say the president was doing one thing or the other, but that there was some implicit bias by what he was saying about players.
You know, I don't want to get into the argument of whether he's racist or not, right? Whether he is or not, it doesn't matter. It's the fact that he didn't treat human beings like human beings who wanted to be accepted, seen, and accepted for who they are. If you're the president of the United States, I feel very strongly that that's your obligation. We haven't been this divisive as a country in a very long time. You know, and as a black man in this country who grew up in the South, there's a lot of things that I've seen and perspective that I have that, you know, a lot of the world doesn't have.
And everything that you were discussing in 17 and 18 applies to what was happening in the summer of 2020. And I mean, when you look back at the fight that you were fighting then, how it applies now, and the fact that now eyes that may have been closed are now open. I mean, what do you think?
I think it was inevitable. We want progress to happen so quickly, and it needs to in a lot of ways. But at the end of the day, we're still human beings.
I love his message, because when he talks about making the world a better place for his daughters, you know, he's not talking about money and wealth making life better. He's talking about justice, yeah, and equity.